Hey guys, welcome back to Mile High Boosted. If you are new here, make sure you check out our other videos on the channel and also hit the subscribe button down below for some really good car content. We do try and upload every day, if not every other day. So we are pretty consistent with that. And so today I'm gonna be painting the brake calipers on my ZX3. All right, so you're gonna start by taking off the wheels, which I have already unbolted. And they're just sitting there because we did end up painting them. And they did turn out really well. So you're gonna take off both of the wheels and tires. Now it's time to do some prep work, which is the most important part when you're painting something. All right, so first things first, you're gonna wanna clean the brake calipers off so that the paint does adhere properly. And it is kind of cold out today, so I will also be heating up the metal with a heat gun before I apply the paint, because paint won't adhere to metal very well if it's cool outside. And it's probably 40 degrees, so kind of on the unsafe side of adhering. So just to be safe, I'm gonna use a heat gun, heat up the brake caliper, and then I'm gonna spray it. All right, so first off, I'm gonna get started with some brake parts cleaner, and I'm gonna get the brake calipers nice and cleaned up. So all right, so now I'm gonna go through with the heat gun and just get it all warmed up. Gotta wait for the heat gun to warm up. There we go. And this will also ensure that it is dry for the paint application. All right, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna wanna make a little tear in the bottom of the bag, like so, just like about like that. And then this is gonna go over this part. And then wherever you made that tear, you're gonna just bring the brake caliper right there and you're gonna stretch it on over so there's no leaks. Right like that. So then all you have is your brake caliper showing. And you're just gonna wanna tuck it back in there to make sure that it's got everything under control and covered. And I'm just gonna spray it like that because I'm not really all that worried about overspray, and because I'm gonna be wrapping the car anyways, so it's not that big of a deal for me, an overspray. So now that this is basically all prepped properly, now it's time to do the first layer. And for your first layer, you do not want it thick whatsoever. So today I have it's kind of like a nitrous blue. It's an engine enamel with ceramic, so it actually withholds heat up to 500 degrees, so it will be safe to go on the brake calipers. So now it's time for the first layer. Gotta shake it real good, make sure it's warm. All right, that's enough for the first layer. All right, it is now time for the second coat of this, so you wanna make sure that you do shake it again. And I felt the surface of this and it isn't cold again, so we are good to apply another layer. And this one can be a little bit thicker than the first. You can get a little bit thicker every time and it'll be all right. All right, now this one's gonna have to sit for a little bit longer since it was thicker than the first. All right, I'm gonna try and keep the brake caliper warm because I do want the paint to apply properly. And so before the next layer, I'm gonna warm it up a little bit with the heat gun and hope that the bag does not warp too much. All All right, now I'm going to apply the next layer. Gotta make sure you get all the angles, because I did notice that there was some that I didn't. And this one can be thick. Alright guys, hey. Alright, as you can see guys, I did actually just finish up all of the blue layers, and it is really, really, really high gloss, which I did not expect. It does say gloss, but usually whenever it says gloss, usually it doesn't look this good. So what I'm gonna do is I also bought a gloss clear coat, which is right here, which is also an engine enamel. So it is just a gloss clear coat. And so I'm going to apply that after this last layer that I just sprayed is done drying. All right guys, so now it is actually time for the clear coat, which I have right here. So you're gonna shake this one really good too before you apply it. It does say a minute on the bottle, but you don't have to go to a minute. You can just shake it. I don't know, I don't usually go a minute and it turns out just fine, especially since it's a brand new bottle. I don't know if it's gonna make it more gloss because it's already really, really shiny. I think it'll just protect it better. So, got the gloss clear with ceramic. So here we go. Since you just sprayed it, you can go a little bit thicker on the first layer, but don't make it too thick. Although it will be hard to see because it's clear. All right, so now I am going to apply the final clear coat. And it actually did make it more shiny, and it also made it just look a little more smooth of a finish, because it did look a little rough with just the blue paint, but the clear coat actually did make it look a little more smooth. So now I'm on the last coat of clear coat, and I'll take this off, I'll get the tire bolted up, and then I'll show you guys how it looks. All right, so there's the final coat of clear. And now I'm just gonna really carefully take off this bag. You can actually just tear one side, like you'll see me do right here, like so. And that makes it a lot easier to pull off. Oh, that is looking gorgeous. That looks so amazing. In a few seconds, once the paint dries on my hand, I'll show you guys more up close and in depth of the finish that it created. And so they do look absolutely fantastic. It did turn out way better than I had anticipated. And as you can see, it does make the car look a lot better. And this is the all right guys, so this paint color is not gonna be staying on here. I'm also gonna be painting on the trim probably this weekend with Kenny. He's coming back to Colorado for the weekend. And I'm gonna just show you before and after of the brake calipers, because I have not yet done the front one on the right side, since I only have two jack stands currently, so I'm only able to take off two of the wheels at the same time. I'm gonna get you guys some rolling shots, so let me get these wheels bolted back on and torqued real quick, and then I'll just drive back and forth on my street with the camera in a certain place so you guys can see how they look. And just remember that the front one is still not done yet, so if you want a comparison of what it kind of does to the car, you can look at the front wheel and then the back wheel, and then you'll see that it does add a lot to the vehicle. I've been fucking hoes and popping pillies, man, I feel just like a rock star. All my brothers got that gas and they always be smoking like a rock star. Fucking with me, call up on the Uzi and
show up, man, them the shot toss. When my homies pull up on your block, they make that thing go gratata. Fucking hoes and popping pillies, man, I feel just like a rockstar.
Jumping in the pool and I ain't got on no bra. Hit the front of back, pulling on the tracks.
As you guys can see, the wheels on this side are actually black. And then you can see the brake caliper very clearly because it's very bright. This brake caliper is not done. But on the other side, we haven't even touched it. Because I'm going to be making a tutorial on how to paint wheels very easily with a rattle can to make it look good. As you can see from this, so make sure you subscribe so you see that video. I still have the center cap out because I did do them white with some black splatter because I do want to do the car white, but then I decided that I think it would look better with it black. So I actually have them right over here drying because as I was doing the brake calipers, I was actually spraying these black